Good morning, children. Today we'll continue with chapter number 14 of science, that is our environment. In the previous videos, I have explained to you about waste and type of waste, that is biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Now today we will learn the need to manage waste and management of non-biodegradable waste. Now the first topic is need to manage. Now what is the need to manage waste? See, waste management is very, very important. To manage waste, to generate less waste, okay, to consume more and to generate less waste is more important, especially in the case of non-biodegradable waste. Why? Because biodegradable waste like garbage and all, it can decompose, it can degrade on its own. Yes, but non-biodegradable such as plastic bags and all will take a lot of time to decompose, and if it is, it may hazard the environment also. Okay, it may harm the environment also. How? See, suppose there can be two conditions. Suppose you put some garbage in a polythene bag and you just throw it. Okay, so what can happen? First of all, the stray animals, like those, the cows who roam around, the dogs which roam around, what can happen? They can eat it, okay, because they are in search of food and they are so desperate, if they are not able to open it, they are going to eat it with the polythene bag, with that plastic bag. So what may happen? The animal may die because of that plastic, because it can stuck up anywhere in its digestive system, and the animal may die. Okay, and secondly, if suppose there are polythenes which are stuck up in our drainage system, in our sewage lines, what will happen? Naturally, the sewage and the drainage system will become blocked, and the water, the drain water, that gutter water, the dirty water will come up and flow on the roads. Okay, so this may happen. So it is very important to manage waste. Now, management of non-biodegradable waste. See, management of non-biodegradable means, waste means, first of all, the proper storage of the waste, okay, to consume only that much what we actually want. So now for proper storage, see, first of all, what do we do? You must have seen your mothers at home, to preserve their food or to keep their food, use it for a long time, they do some preservations. Yes, the most and the general thing, the most important thing is that they refrigerate the things. Yes, if suppose there is some leftover food, we can put it in the refrigerator and then use it in the other meal. Okay, while we have our other meals, we can just reuse it. So what are we doing? We are not throwing that food in the garbage. We are not throwing that food. We are reusing it. We are storing it and then using it later. So same way, we can do so many things to, and if proper storage is done, we can actually use so many things, we can reuse so many things, we can reduce the actually the waste generation, means the generation, the amount of waste which is generated can be actually reduced. So for this, there are basically three R's which are which denotes the waste management of non-biodegradable substances. What are those three R's? Reduce, reuse and recycle. Now what is reduce? See, reduce means actually to lessen the use of anything. Okay, suppose like in the previous videos also I have explained you, suppose you have so many toys. Now you go to the toy shop and you want more. Yes, and you want more, and every time you go and you want more and more. So what is actually, you are not reducing your limits. Yes, you are using so many things and then you are putting it, dumping it in the corner of your house or somewhere in the cupboard or somewhere in the under the bed, in the box. What happens? Things are taken, things are bought, but they are not used. Okay, so we should learn how to reduce the use of anything, whatever we buy. Okay, we should buy only whatever is required. We should not use so many plastic bags. We should actually, whenever we go to the market, we should carry a jute bag or a cloth bag with us, so that we do not take a polythene bag from there. Okay, we should use both sides of the paper, so that the paper is used properly, so that the less number of trees are cut down to produce papers. Okay, so these are the small ways in which you can actually reduce the waste. Okay, some more are that buy only whatever you require. Then avoid using plastic disposable item. This is very important. We should not use disposable items unless and until it is very, very important. Okay, we can use our crockery, we can use our steel utensils instead of using those, because those plastic disposable items, they do not degrade and decompose easily and it takes lots of time and they may be eaten by animals and we know what can happen after that. Okay, now reuse. Reusing thing is like whatever you have, you can, if it, suppose your mama buys a can or a bottle of pickle. Okay, now if the pickle is over, now will she throw that bottle? No. Most of us, what do we do actually? Some of them, they throw it, but most of us, we actually reuse those bottles. Okay, when they are empty, when there is no more pickle, we wash them and then we use it to store something else. Okay, some spices, some other food grain or whatever. Okay, in the kitchen. So things can be reused. Okay, your old pouches can be used to put some other stationery items. Your old notebooks, suppose there are pages left in your old notebooks, they can be torn and then you can bind them and then you can again use them as your rough notebooks. Okay, so there are ways in which you can reuse things and lessen the waste. Next is recycle. Now, how do we recycle things? See, plastics, metals, glass, they all can be recycled. But the only thing is they should actually reach their proper place. If you throw plastic, glass or anything here and there along with the kitchen garbage, it will be very difficult to separate it. Yes? So there are bins. There are blue bins, there are green bins, there are black bins, there are red bins for disposal of different items. Okay? They are not found everywhere. But you must have seen people when they come to your door, those municipality people, when they come to your door to pick up the garbage, sometimes they ask you to give the garbage in two different bins or in two different bags or cloth bags. In one, we keep the kitchen garbage because that is easily decomposable, that can be degraded easily. And in one, we keep the plastic, the e-waste, metals, cans, okay, because that can go for recycling. Now, what is recycling? Recycling is basically a process in which things go to the factory and then they are heated up in the high temperature and then recycled. They are remade. Okay? So, what all things can be recycled? We can recycle papers, we can recycle glass, we can recycle plastic and metals. Okay? Paper can, all these things can be melted together in a high temperature. Don't try it at home. Okay, these things are done in factories. Okay, these things are done in big industries. So they, what do? They heat up these things. Okay, they separate these things. They heat up these things together. And then they mold it again into a different object or a different thing. Like plastic things, plastic bottles. Okay, the broken plastic, the pieces of broken plastic. They are melted together. And then new buckets, mugs, chairs are formed. Okay, glasses, suppose if a glass is broken at your home, what will you do? You will naturally throw it. And then what will they do? The vendors who take this scrap, or they are going to give it to the scrap dealers, and they will give it to the place, take it to the place where all these recycling thing is happening. Okay, and then things can be recycled. So we can, at least at our level, we can put these things separately and then dump it or give it to the vendors, the scrap dealers, so that they can send all those things there and it can be recycled. At least with this, we can help in saving our environment. Okay? So, producing less waste is very important. Reducing waste is important. Reusing things is important. And helping in recycling thing is very, very important. So, I hope you have learned about management of non-biodegradable waste. In the next video, I will explain you about management of biodegradable waste.